the show that's changing the world. Now you don't just listen to the show, you live it. Live from the headquarters of Ramsey Solutions, it's the Dave Ramsey Show, where debt is dumb, cash is king, and the paid-off home mortgage has taken the place of the BMW as the status symbol of choice. I'm Dave Ramsey, your host. You jump in. We'll talk about your life and your money. It is a free call at 888-825-5225. It's 888-825-5225. You jump in. We'll talk about you right in front of you. Julie is with us in Baton Rouge. Hi, Julie. How are you?
Hi, Dave. I'm good. How are you?
Better than I deserve. What's up?
Great. I wanted to see what you had to say about what could I tell my mother about doing a reverse mortgage, pros or cons. I know you're not for them, but... give me some ammunition I can give to her.
Why is she wanting to do a reverse mortgage?
She's just not making her retirement, is not bringing in enough income. She's a widow. She's 67. Mm-hmm. And that's her solution to bringing in some extra income. Mm. It's just my brother and myself, and we don't look to get anything. You know, her house is probably the only thing that we would get as an inheritance. Mm-hmm. And you know, we told her we're fine with that. We don't need her house. Mm-hmm. So, didn't know if there was any negative.
Oh, there's a lot of negatives. Yeah. It's a horrible product. Her home is paid for.
If we were willing to walk away from her house, you know, what other negative would there be that she could look out for?
Well, they have unbelievably high interest rates, horrible rates. They have unbelievably high fees, and there's a high incidence of fraud because they call on and work with the elderly, and so there's a percentage of them are just shysters. Now, there are quote-unquote legitimate, lots of legitimate reverse mortgages, but but the fees are ridiculous and the interest rates are ridiculous. It's not a good product.
Okay.
And the only time it is brought up is in, you know, desperate situations, which usually when I'm desperate, that usually leads me to be stupid shortly thereafter. So what's this house worth?
It would probably go for about $160 today.
And where does she live? In Baton Rouge? She,
yes, outskirts, yeah. Okay. Outer area.
Mm-hmm. How long has she lived in that house?
Oh, 25 years.
Mm, okay.
If it's not paid for, it's very, very close to being paid for. Mm-hmm. You know, she just needs to figure out something to get some more income.
Yeah.
It wouldn't help her to sell it and move to a smaller because rent around here is, you know, $1,000 a month. She couldn't get anything cheaper or smaller.
Why not? I mean, you wouldn't have to rent if she could sell it and move to something cheaper and put money in her pocket. And what if she bought a $100,000 house and put $60,000 in her pocket or a $100,000 condo?
Yeah. I don't think she's willing to move for one. And because if, you know, she... In her mind, she doesn't have those monthly expenses right now. She just has her utilities and same thing she would have if she were renting something.
Well, I wasn't suggesting she rent something. If you sell a $160,000 house for cash
and you
buy a $100,000 condominium for cash, you still don't have any monthly expenses and you have $60,000 in your pocket.
Right. Okay.
And then that begins to take care of things. How's her health?
It's good, yeah. I mean, she'll live a long time. She should live a long time.
Well, the principle of the reverse mortgage is it's the reverse of a mortgage. You receive payments instead of paying payments, and your balance goes up instead of going down.
Mm-hmm.
So you're every month or further in debt again.
Right.
At the end, at some point, and it is... it's not that far into the program. I mean, it fools you when you actually look at the numbers. In other words, they're going to make sure that when they get the house, it's got a ton of equity. So it's not like they're going to let the balance run all the way up to 160. They're going to let that balance run up to maybe 120 or 130.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I didn't know the percentages.
Yeah, and
she just told me she was checking into it, and I don't even know that she will tell me, you know, if she's going to do it. I just wanted to, you know.
Well, I mean, you ask my opinion. My opinion is it's a really, really bad idea. I would find some other ways to skin this cat, and that's selling and moving down. I don't recommend putting a 67-year-old that's debt-free back into a mortgage. But I would do a traditional mortgage, put $100,000, $200,000, $150,000 in your pocket, invest that, and have that investment income coming in to pay the mortgage with before I would do a reverse mortgage. It makes better mathematical sense. But I don't like any of those options, and I wouldn't do any of those. If it was a relative of mine, I would tell them to move down into a house they can afford. Because the fact that they haven't saved any money has put her in a position that now she can't afford this house. She's living in a home she can't afford. That's the sad truth of the situation. The other possibility, of course, depending on where you and your brother stand, is if you're able to begin to supplement her income monthly, if you guys want to do that, for her to keep the house. But, you know, I'm unwilling to move. I can't help somebody in those situations. I mean, you have to decide that you're going to do something wise, or you're going to do something that feels good on the short term, but long term has really horrible implications, and that's the reverse mortgage. Not a fan. Nathan is with us in Salt Lake City. Hi, Nathan. How are you?
Hi, this is Jason.
Jason, I'm sorry. How can I help?
I have two questions, one about insurance and one about wills.
Which one do you want to do?
I'll do wills.
Okay.
What is the difference between getting just a will and having a trust with the will? I'm getting, I guess, conflicting information. I was interested in finding out, I guess, I understand what a will is, but how the trust follows in line with that, or how you incorporate the two together.
Well, there are several types of trusts. Usually when someone asks this question, they're talking about a living trust, which is where you move all of your assets into a trust while you're alive. And
okay.
And then the will is... in a sense, doesn't do a lot. You still need a will, but it doesn't do a lot because everything's already moved into the trust, and the trust has direct, you have the beneficial interest, and then all you're willing is the beneficial interest. Let's say you had 10 pieces of property, you put them all in the trust, or 10 items, and you put them all in the trust, then you don't have to name, okay, all these 10 items are in my will. Instead, the only thing in your will is the trust. One thing. You see, and what that does is it does help with your local probate in your state. Most of the time, a living trust is not a good idea for multiple reasons. It costs more to put a living trust in place than it saves you in probate tax in most states, unless you've got a multi-million dollar estate. Number two, a living trust is a complete pain in the butt to operate your life out of because you don't own anything anymore. It's in the name of the trust. So you get ready to sell your house, you have to get the trustee to sign everything. You get ready to do your investments and move them around, you have to get the trustee to sign everything. So operating your life out of a trust is a pain in the butt, again, unless there's a multi-million dollar estate and a real reason to do this that makes it worth the hassle. But if it's just a normal estate that's under $5 million, having a living trust is a joke. I wouldn't spend my money or my time on it or the hassle. But if you've got a $20 million estate, there starts to be some places for a living trust in parts of it. And that's the trust you would use while you're alive. Lots of trusts are formed upon death or prior to death in multi-million dollar estates. But lots of trusts are formed upon death in smaller estates. That's fine. But while you're alive, I don't see much, I'm not much of a fan of the living trust while you're alive for most people.
Hi, I'm Dr. Bob Marshall, PhD, host of Healthline. XenoX is a vital, safe, food-rich source of iodine, essential for thyroid health and for women, life-critical for healthy reproductive system and healthy breasts. Buy two bottles, get the third one free. Call 800-370-3447. That's 800-370-3447.
Healthline at 2:30 Monday through Friday on KCAA 1050 AM.
Hello, everyone. This is Nina MD, Fusion of Science and Beauty. Listen to my show every Wednesday night, 6 p.m., KCAA 1050, where I'm going to give you the latest, greatest on anti-aging.
With other companies, I always felt I was not kept in the loop. So coming to the final day at signing, I wasn't sure exactly what was going on. I just knew I had to sign a bunch of paper. But with Churchill Mortgage, I knew exactly what was expected of me and what was going to happen. There was no surprises.
Call Churchill Mortgage today or visit us online to discover why we're the only mortgage company Dave Ramsey has ever endorsed.
This is KCAA.
Hi, I'm John Elway. Did you know that John Elway's Crown Toyota is the largest volume Toyota dealer in the Inland Empire? Here to give you the details is the General Sales Manager, Kara Brindley.
Well, John Elway's Crown Toyota, we listen to you. And ever since we've changed to our new process, we post our one price, which is our best price, up front on every single vehicle. Now, customers are telling me they look forward to buying their next car from us.
So come visit John Elway's Crown Toyota today in the giant Ontario Auto Center where the 10 and 15 meet.
One price, simple, no games.
Like to spend a few days in another world? Then write this down. Golden Bear Cottages, Big Bear Lake. Now, listen, this is not some corporate-owned operation. It's family-owned and operated by some real nice people. Unique? Oh, you bet. Golden Bear Cottages features 28 one-of-a-kind cabins on a 5-acre historic site. Great for families, couples, and groups. And cabins are available with 1 to 7 bedrooms. Golden Bear Cottages is just a stone's throw from Big Bear Lake and super close to 3 great ski areas. Now, I could go on all day about Golden Bear Cottages in Big Bear, but to see everything, just go to goldenbear.net. Again, goldenbear.net. Golden Bear Cottages in Big Bear. Clean, comfortable, and affordable. Check them out. goldenbear.net.
Parents and grandparents, listen this week on Relationships 2.0 with Dr. Michelle Skeen, as her guest will be Dr. Victoria Dunkley, child psychologist and author of Reset Your Child's Brain. Learn about how to end meltdowns, raise grades, and boost the social skills of your children Tuesday afternoon at 3 on KCAA 1050 AM.
Hey, this is Steve Sanchez, and do you know in 2007, I went off to the doctor for a basic checkup, and he informed me, Steve, you got plaque built up around your heart, and you're going to need stents. I informed him, with no offense, doc, I need a second opinion. I go off to a naturopathic doctor, and he introduces me to something called Zango. It's a juice made of the whole mangosteen fruit. You know, the mangosteen fruit has been used for centuries for healing. So, hey, what do I have to lose? I tried it. 3 months later, I go back to my cardiologist, no plaque, no stents, and I'm proud to say 7.5 years later, I'm stent free. I want to turn you on to Zango because it's the only true 100% mangosteen fruit juice. It's patented. In fact, the Mayo Clinic is paying attention because they're doing an extensive study because they cannot ignore all the testimonials around the world. I want to give you a free sample of the Zango juice today. Simply call 888-309-5656. That's 888-309-5656 for your free mangosteen juice sample today from the company called Zango.
Kcaa.
Thank you for joining us, America. It's a free call at 888-825-5225. You jump in. We will talk. Lee is with us in Phoenix. Hi, Lee. How are you?
Hi, I'm doing great. Thanks. Good to talk to you.
You too.
I'm just wondering, I've just received a small inheritance, and we're just wondering, my husband and I, if we should put it towards 20% down for our first home purchase, or if you would suggest that we put it into mutual funds for our retirement.
Are you debt-free?
Pretty close. Just some student loans left, about $12,000 left.
How much was the small inheritance?
$35,000.
Okay, and you have $12,000 in student loans.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, do you have any money saved?
Yes, we have about $12,000 in savings right now.
Okay, all right, very cool. So we're dealing
and
with
no other debt or anything.
So we're dealing with $47,000 in savings,
mm-hmm.
and a $12,000 student loan.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I would write a check today and pay off the student loan.
Okay.
I would set aside a fund out of the remaining $35,000 for emergencies, and that would be 3 to 6 months of household expenses. What's your household income?
It's about $40,000 a year right now.
Okay, so if I set aside $10,000 of the $35,000 for your rainy day fund, now you're debt-free mm-hmm. and you have a good rainy day fund. That leaves you $25,000.
Okay.
Yes, I would buy a house with that.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate the call. Open phones at 888-825-5225. Paul is in Pensacola, Florida. Hey, Paul, how are you?
Hey, Dave. Thank you for taking my call, and
sure.
Thank you for what you do.
Thank you.
So, I wanted to tell you, I really appreciate what you do. I gave my grown kids, the Financial Peace University, because I really endorse what you do, and
thank
I wanted
you.
Them to share in that inheritance.
Thank you. How can I help today?
My question is this. I'm 59, my wife's 58. We are completely debt-free. Within the next few years, going to be looking at stepping down from full-time positions. I was recently approached by a friend of mine through my realtor that connected me with this guy that flips houses professionally, and we connected, and he asked me about partnering with him financially and getting a percentage of the return on that, and I want to know your opinion on that. I flipped a number of houses, but have not done it in a number of years, and so he's connected me with him.
Okay. So you have the cash to do this?
Yes, sir, I do.
In cash?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. You probably, it sounds like you've been around me enough to know I'm not fond of partnerships. I think the only ship that won't sail is a partnership.
Yes, sir.
And it's a really, really good way to get burned if you structure this wrong. There is a way to share in the profits and make it more of a joint venture if you want to do these kinds of deals. If I were in your shoes, the way I would structure it is he finds the house and you buy the house and own the house. And if there are funds dispersed to do the remodel that he's managing, then you're going to disperse those funds, but you're only going to disperse them as the remodel occurs, right?
Yes, sir.
You're not going to just give him a check and hope he does it. And so at any point in that process, if he just leaves the planet and takes off to somewhere else, you don't really have to find him. You've just got to finish the house out and sell it, and you won't get burned because you're the owner of the house. Then let's say he does follow through and there's not any problems and you end up, you know, after renovation with $100,000 invested in a property that's worth $200,000 and you sell it, you could split the profits at the closing table and he gets half of the profits, when the property closes only, no other time.
Okay.
And until it sells. In other words, the house is not flipped until it sells.
That's correct.
Where these things get, where people get burned is when they don't flip or when they get halfway through and they lose their emotional energy to complete. And the financial partner is the one that gets burned. But he could get, for his hustle, for finding the deal, managing the renovation, managing the resale, and in a sense, you become a, quote, silent financial partner. In return for his hustle, he gets a percentage of the profits, half or otherwise. You can decide, doesn't have to be half, but whatever you decide, that is a, you know, an agreement between the two of you as a joint venture. And he can get paid for that legally without a real estate license for digging up the deal, getting the property sold. Now, he can't get paid a real estate commission. That's illegal in every state unless he has a license. But he can get paid when the property closes on the resale. Until then, sir, you're at risk.
Okay.
But if he wants to be joint owner with you in an LLC, no, I wouldn't do it.
Okay.
You don't need him that bad.
No. A question that I had was, because I am buying rentals as a part of my retirement income, I was curious if I would be better off taking that money and going ahead and putting it into another rental versus putting it in an investment with him.
Well, it depends on the numbers.
Yeah.
If he is getting some really good deals on properties and he's a real bird dog, he knows how to turn over the rocks and get the rabbits to run out, you know, you might make some quick money. You might turn your, what's the amount of money allocated for this next rental deal that you've got in mind?
Well, I was between $60,000 and $100,000.
Okay, let's say you dropped $100,000 in, like I was talking about a while ago,
okay,
and you were able to add $25,000 or $30,000 to that on one flip.
Okay.
that would change the whole complexion of your rental purchase, right? If you, even if you just did one with him. But if you're not going to make that, if you're going to make $5,000 on a flip net to you after it's all done, heck with that.
Sure.
That's not worth the trouble. So you guys need to be buying on flips. You got to buy 70% of value minus repairs, or you're going to lose money on a flip eventually.
Yes.
And if you can't buy at that, then you're not going to be in a deal, and it's not going to work for you. So that means you're literally buying a $200,000 property for $140,000 minus repairs.
Okay.
Or you don't do the deal. So, you know, because you're going to, by the time you do resale and you got commissions and you could have had the money making money while you're sitting on it, and so there's lost opportunity cost on the money. You've got closing costs on the purchase, closing costs on the resale. You got property taxes and insurance. You've got the fact that you always miss your construction estimate unless you've done 100 of these. And by the time you finish all of that, you know, you're what sounds like a 30% gross margin isn't even close. And so if you're going to make $5,000 or $10,000, I wouldn't screw with it.
Okay.
But if you can make some, if he can walk you into a sweet deal, as long as you maintain the ownership position, I'm fine with it. But if he starts doing some kind of, you know, twisted sideways deal where he wants you to finance something and, you know, all this kind of, he just needs your signature. Oh Lord, you're about to get taken to the cleaners.
Okay. Well, that was part of what was being talked about.
Nah, just move on. Unless you can get this deal real clean and simple. But listen, hey, I used to do this. I used to be the bird dog after I went broke. I knew how to dig up deals. I never had any trouble digging up deals. And so I would dig up deals, and I would either put guys into the deal and make a spread on the front end. Like, you know, if he brought you a $150,000 house for $100,000, you'd pay him $10,000 for that deal. And he could walk away and you'd have a rental, right?
Sure.
Yeah, easy. You'd be happy to close on that at 110. And so on. So I did stuff like that, and I did stuff where I actually helped people buy the property. They owned the property, and when we flipped it, I made some money off the back. But I never asked them to finance it for me. That's just a nightmare. This is the Dave Ramsey Show.
Hi, I'm Dr. Bob Marshall, PhD, host of Healthline. XenoX is a vital, safe, food-rich source of iodine, essential for thyroid health and for women, life-critical for healthy reproductive system and healthy breasts. Buy two bottles, get the third one free. Call 800-370-3447. That's 800-370-3447.
Healthline at 2:30 Monday through Friday on KCAA 1050 AM.
This is KCAA.
California headline news, an increase in shark activity in the state. A woman sees a bite taken out of her surfboard in Morro Bay.
It was under me. It surfaced. It took the board, and I was out of there. I don't know what. I never looked back.
Eleanor Dempsey, the hungry shark, apparently a six-foot-long great white, popular beach near La Jolla, evacuated over the weekend when a shark was spotted there. Wes Craven has lost his battle against brain cancer. The horror movie maestro dying at his Los Angeles home, best known for movies like Scream and Nightmare on Elm Street. He was 76. A surprise political announcement in Los Angeles.
As you probably could have guessed by this moment, I have decided in 2020 to run for president.
That's how Kanye West finished off a 10-minute-long acceptance speech after receiving the Michael Jackson Vanguard Video Award Sunday night at the MTV Video Music Awards. First few hundred Los Angeles police officers will start wearing body cameras today. Geico weather, another day of warm and dry conditions throughout much of the state. Jeff Scott, California News.
Call Quicken Loans now at 800-QUICKEN to see if you qualify for the government's Home Affordable Refinance Program, or HARP. And for 5 years in a row now, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction. And for the second year in a row, they've also ranked us highest in mortgage servicing. Call 800-QUICKEN or visit quickenloans.com.
Visit jdpower.com for award information. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender, licensed in all 50 states. NMLSconsumeraccess.org, number 3030.
When you're running your own business, you're bound to be busy. Too busy. Too busy worrying about your budget. Too busy scheduling appointments. Too busy to build a website for your business. And because you're too busy, it has to be easy. And that's where Wix.com comes in. With Wix.com, it's easy for you to create your stunning website. Go to Wix.com and create your website today. It's easy and free. That's Wix.com.
Controlled? Well, maybe. Chaos? Definitely. Tune in weekday mornings, Monday through Friday at 8 a.m. for Controlled Chaos with Gary Garver, Jigga, Dave, and Mary Tonga. KCAA, 1050 a.m. You have to hear it to believe it.
Hey, buddy. I heard the drought's moving in, muscling in on your turf. To make matters worse, the man keeps telling you to limit your spigot. That drought is bad news, no fooling. But me and my boys can help. The Water Boys, on the Water Zone, Thursday nights at 6. We'll help you protect your turf and save water. And hey, don't worry about it. Consider it a gift.
Yeah, Louie, you heard the boss. We gotta listen in at 6 p.m. on Thursday nights.
Okay, Vinny, you got it. The Water Zone, Thursday nights at 6 p.m. I'll tell our lawn it's now protected.
The Water Zone on KCAA, 1050 a.m.
Here's your Money Minute with Market Wrap host Mo Ansari.
If you follow the markets, you've probably been getting seasick lately. But what if I told you that market volatility can be a good thing? If you're a bargain hunter, this is your coupon. So keep your shopping list handy. If you're a long-term investor with plenty of time before retirement, the money going into your 401k each month will buy more shares when the markets are down. And if you have a good financial plan, you can relax while others worry, because that plan will carry you beyond today's headlines. Of course, you should always consider professional guidance before making any financial decisions. That's your Money Minute. I'm Mo Ansari.
For more tips on investing during market volatility and other investment topics, listen to Market Wrap weekdays at 5 p.m. on this station. For a free consultation with Mo Ansari, call 800-388-9700. That's 800-388-9700.
Compaq Asset Management is a registered investment advisor. Funds custodian, Fidelity Institutional Wealth Services, member FINRA SIPC.
From the KCAA Weather Center, I'm Tom Ladd. For this afternoon, it'll be sunny and a high near 91. South wind at 5, becoming calm. Clear tonight, low around 62. A west wind at 10 to 15, becoming light and variable in the evening. Winds could gust as high as 20 miles per hour. Sunny Tuesday and a high near 86 degrees. Calm wind out of the west at 5 in the afternoon. Patchy fog after 11 p.m. Tuesday night. Otherwise partly cloudy. Expect a low around 60. That's your weather forecast for this hour. From the station at leaves no listener behind. NBC News Radio, AM 1050, KCAA.
Ramsey Solutions, Keith and Kathy are with us. Hey, guys, how are you?
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Dave, we're doing good.
Welcome, welcome. Where do you guys live?
We live just outside Austin, Texas.
Well, welcome to Nashville. Good to have you.
Thank you.
Here to do your debt-free scream.
Yes, we are.
I love it.
Finally done.
You're finally here. How much have you paid off?
We've paid off $30,000 in the last 18 months.
Way to go. Making what kind of money?
$77,000 to $89,000.
Cool. What do you guys do for a living?
I'm an engineer, and
I do this.
You do this? This being the four kids standing in front of you, what are their names and ages?
We got Sydney, who's 10, Timothy, who's 8, Jordan, who is now 7, and Alex, who's 9.
Right down the line. There we go. Absolutely. Perfect. I love it. Congratulations. So what kind of debt was the $30,000?
Well, we finished paying off our house.
Oh!
That was the last push.
Wow!
Finally. Can we say finally finished
yes.
paying off our house?
Wow. So 18 months is not the whole story then?
No, it's not.
Well, tell me the story.
Is that me? Well, we found you early, like, I think 2003. Mm-hmm. And as right before I got pregnant with her, we got through the steps really quick. We didn't have a lot of debt, maybe $5,000, knocked that out, got mm-hmm. emergency fund, mm-hmm. had another kid. Right. And then right before this one, our last one was born, we had just a lot of life happen. Like for 6 years, it was on top of our fourth kid. In less than 4 years, we had a real hard personal situation happen that mm-hmm. kind of took the wind out of our sails. Mm-hmm. And we had tons of medical, 6 surgeries, mom out of capacity for a year.
Wow.
He had a layoff for 6 months, severance.
Whoa.
So we had just a lot of life. And we were kind of really, you know, it was just hard to kind of get by. And then we met a new group of friends, and they started asking us a lot about Ramsey. And we thought, well, even though we're following the principles, we just need to kind of pick ourselves up and get this thing done. And mm-hmm. that's what happened.
Okay. All right. Well, you thank goodness when you hit that rough patch, you were debt-free except the house.
Absolutely. And we didn't overbuy either, so.
Yeah, and that kept you under control, and because you'd be in a real mess digging out right now if it hadn't been for that.
Exactly.
So then when you get past the rough patch, you just get reinvigorated and go ahead and knock out the house. That's pretty much it.
Absolutely. I didn't know he had been throwing some extra money from a raise to it. And last September, he came to me and said, you know, we can get this done by December, maybe January of 2016. And I was like, okay. And so with the encouragement from our small group, hey, small group, we got it done.
So what's your home worth?
Now it's about $210,000.
And your house is paid for.
And it's done.
How weird.
It is so weird.
How does that feel?
Great.
It feels fantastic.
Thank you,
I mean,
Dave.
after all you guys have been through, you don't owe a dime in the world.
No.
No.
There's got to be a piece that goes with that.
That's the big thing. The financial piece is amazing, and that's I love telling people about it, so thank you, Dave.
Well, thank you, guys. You did it. I didn't do it. You're the hero. You're the hero. I just showed you how.
Yeah, listening to you every day, you pushed me that way.
Made you believe you could do it, and then you went and did it. That's how this works. Well, congratulations, you guys. So what, obviously the rough patch is there, and the other processes you go through, and you just persevered, or you kind of took a little time off and didn't go into the hole, but didn't really make any progress for a while, and then come back and attack it. What do you tell people the key to getting out of debt is, now that you've been on this journey?
Staying on a budget. Mm. That's whether you're completely capturing every dime or just staying within your means, and mm-hmm. that's the big one, is staying in within that parameter. That
we know you stayed within your means, but you probably didn't do a good job of the written budget during some of those rough patches.
The budget was there, but we just didn't capture the extra.
Okay.
We spent it. Like, yes, we spent it on convenience.
You medicated.
Eating out.
Medicated the situation
like I
a
just,
little bit.
Yeah, eating out more, all that kind of stuff. Yeah. We just did it so we weren't able to keep it all together to really go forward.
That makes sense. And then all of a sudden, then when you start to kind of feel whole again, so to speak, you can turn up the heat again because you've got all the tools in front of you.
Exactly. Exactly. Cool. It was good to have that margin. So I'll never regret. We regret in some ways that we, what am I trying to say? That we could have done it sooner, maybe mm-hmm. 4 years earlier, mm-hmm. but we had a lot going on. Mm-hmm. And thank God we had the margin financially to mm-hmm. not be stressed about finances during that time. Mm-hmm. But the one thing we don't regret is that they will remember this day. And I just can't regret that.
Oh, I wouldn't. No, they're here. Mm-hmm. And this is family tree changing stuff right here.
Absolutely.
So have they been practicing from Austin, Texas, their debt-free scream?
Yes, they have.
Yes.
Okay.
And so they're the reason we're here.
Okay. So you would have just done the phone call. Yeah, but
he would have.
Yeah, you got to make a trip, and we have to make a memory out of this. And so
we got to meet Dave.
We're going to Dave's office, eating some of Dorothy's cookies. We're going to do the full-on experience.
Exactly.
All right. Very cool. Well, I'm proud of you guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You ought to feel very weird because you are.
Yes.
In a good way.
In a good way.
Congratulations. And you think the kids really understand where you are?
Yes, they see it every month since they were little. When we still owed over $80,000, we have a sheet, and each square, it was $100. And they've colored in those squares ever since over $80,000. So after we went and did the final wire, had our party at our house that night, they colored in those last 18 squares. They even paid for the last square.
Ah.
And they were part of it.
Very cool. That's fun. I like that. Neat. Very cool. All right. Keith and Kathy and the team, $30,000 paid off in 18 months. That's house and everything, making $77,000 to $89,000. Count it down. Let's hear a debt-free scream.
All righty, guys, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
We're debt-free!
I love it. Congratulations, you guys. Congratulations. Very, very, very well done. Kids did a great job on that one. That's awesome, guys. That is very cool. Well, it's very cool when somebody walks in here and they discover this material and this idea of being debt-free and this belief in themselves that it can happen, and they just line up and they become debt-free very, very quickly. That's wonderful. It's also even more wonderful in some ways for people to come in here and they've got an authentic, real life story where life sucked for part of the journey. And they still work their way through it. They still take the journey. They still can stand here with their kids coloring in the squares, remembering the day that they traveled to Nashville to make a memory and say, that's the last time our family ever owed money. Now, when that 10-year-old is married and is 26 and his wife wants to go lease a car, you think that's going to happen? I think there's a very low probability of that happening. When she wants to go buy a house he can't afford, or that, you know, young lady standing there, the 8-year-old, marries a guy who wants to go $100,000 in student loan debt to get his master's degree in German polka history, you think she's going to go along with that? No. I think their lives were changed. That's how a family tree has changed. It's not just knowledge. It's the experience. Creating an experience that says, we now identify our family this way. Ramseys don't do this. Ramseys do this. Ramseys tithe. Ramseys give and are generous. Ramseys save. Ramseys have an emergency fund. See, fill in your family name there. Fill in your name and make it an attribute, a character quality of your family, that financial wisdom is part of the process. That's when you change your family tree, baby. That's when the whole thing shifts. You start identifying your family with, well, Ramseys have never had any money. No, no. Ramseys know how to build wealth. Ramseys know how to invest. Ramseys know how to get good buys. Ramseys are careful. Fill in your family name. This is the Dave Ramsey Show.
Jump off that exhausting hamster wheel and into balanced living with Dr. Marissa. Her mission, to be a beneficial presence on the planet. Her purpose, to be your personal advocate to live, love, laugh, learn. Her life motto, don't die wondering. Take back your life with Dr. Marissa Fay.
Every Thursday night at 7 on KCAA, NBC News Radio, AM 1050.
We're looking at some tough questions. And
tough
stuff, tough financial questions. We went out on the streets of Nashville and asked some big financial questions. Watch this.
This is KCAA.
We are ambitious. We are proud of our work. We are Kubota. With Kubota's economical MX 4800 and MX 5200 utility ag tractors, we simply get more done. Full of big features, Kubota MX Series tractors are packed with up to 54.7 horsepower Kubota diesel engines, powerful transmission options, and more. Test drive one today during the More Power to You sales event. Fueling your ambition, we are Kubota.
What have I learned so far? Well, I've learned there's no one right path for everyone.
I've learned that without my high school diploma, I can only do so much. My options were limited, very limited. I found a free personalized learning program with Learn for Life that has a flexible schedule so I can keep my job while earning my high school diploma. I found a new career with training opportunities that would jumpstart my future. What I've learned so far, I've learned that I could change my life.
Are you 14 to 19 years old and looking for a free high school diploma program with flexible meeting times? This program allows you to keep your job or important family responsibilities while earning your high school diploma. If you've fallen behind on credits or dropped out of school completely, get back on track with free tutoring, a caring faculty, and one-on-one attention. For more information on how to reach your graduation goal, visit learnforlife.org. That's L-E-A-R-N, the number 4, L-I-F-E.org. Or enroll today by calling 877-360-LEARN. That's 877-360-LEARN.
Parents and grandparents, listen this week on Relationships 2.0 with Dr. Michelle Skeen, as her guest will be Dr. Victoria Dunkley, child psychologist and author of Reset Your Child's Brain. Learn about how to end meltdowns, raise grades, and boost the social skills of your children Tuesday afternoon at 3 on KCAA 1050 AM. Who needs friends or Facebook when you have KCAA's Brant line? You can get it all out at 909-353-1050 with no interruptions. Do you want to tell us how much you're learning from Dave Ramsey?
Keep your expenses down when you're a student.
Maybe you stink, you can't take a shower at your place, and you really need to.
Work it down there at the largest online retailer in the United States, and they have him loading them trucks, I sure as need a shower.
Perhaps you're having money issues.
Motel 6, the Decker rates up, it used to be like $42, now they're up to $59. Got about $4,000 in the bank, but working part-time, I don't want to whittle into that, might need it later.
Whatever you need to get off your chest, we are here for you. Give us a call on the Rant line at 909-353-1050 and rant. We'll listen, we won't interrupt, and we may even play your rant on the station that leaves no listener behind, KCAA 1050 AM.
America, this is the Dave Ramsey Show. We're glad you're here. Open phones at 888-825-5225. You jump in and we will talk. It is a free call. Our question of the day comes from blinds.com. If you need your windows to keep out the August heat, then as well as the winter cold, then you need to check out the cellular insulating shades at blinds.com. You can pick a single, double, or triple cell thickness while lowering your energy bills year-round. Couldn't be any easier or more affordable than blinds.com. Today's question comes from Andre. How much disability insurance should a person have for their income? I'm a physician, and I currently make about $300,000 a year. Well, most of the time, Andre, you're limited at much above $200,000, sometimes much above $300,000. And most people carry about 70%, the most you can get that I've ever seen, 70, 75%, without getting into some kind of a weird policy. Weird translating into much, much more expensive. And so something to think about there. So here's what you need to do. You get as much as you can get before the price goes bananas. And that might only be 50% in your situation as a physician. So you want to check that and make that decision. But 75%, somewhere in there. I've seen policies that cover as much as $300,000 total, which would be income of $400,000 in most cases. So, or $500,000, that kind of a thing. But it's just, you have to look at anything above that, they're not going to cover without getting into weird expensive Lloyd's of London type policies. If budgeting has been a struggle for you, I got some good news. most of us have struggled with it at one time or another. You need to try something new. It's called Every Dollar. Every Dollar makes budgeting easy and fun. Now, most people don't do a budget because they think it's either too time-consuming or it's too restrictive. I don't want my budget telling me what to do. Well, that's not what our Every Dollar budgeters are saying. They jump on Facebook, they say things like they are handling their money instead of their money handling them. They also love that their budget is accessible and at their fingertips. So we've got over 500,000 people now at everydollar.com building a budget, and you can do that in about 10 minutes, and it's free. So check it out, everydollar.com, the best budget tool out there, everydollar.com. This is how you take control of your money. And you can download the app for free for your Apple phone as well, your iPhone app, and it's completely free, everydollar.com. Now, if you want the bank connectivity to download your bank charges directly into your Every Dollar budget, you can get that as well. The banks charge us for that, and so we charge you. It's that simple. If they would give it to us for free, we would give it to you for free. But the money we've invested to build everydollar.com, millions of dollars over the last several years, it is absolutely incredible. That's why there's, in just a few months old, well over a half a million people using the thing. It's pretty crazy how quick this thing's growing. Pretty fun, I'll tell you that. So, open phones at 888-825-5225. Karen is in Atlanta. Hi, Karen. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, Dave?
Better than I deserve. What's up?
Dave, I am in real estate. My husband just started working with me. We have $9,000 in our business account. But what I've been doing is paying myself a certain amount every week, $500 a week, and then he's getting about the same amount every week, and then he goes and works for Uber in the evening. So, but we have a student loan of $14,000 and a car loan of $22,000. So I feel like it's crazy having that money just sitting in the business account when we could be paying down the debt.
Yeah, and when you say you're in real estate, you're real estate brokers?
I'm a realtor.
So why do you need retained earnings as a realtor?
Well, I just keep it there, just honestly, just to be on the safe side in case.
Safe side of what?
If business happened to go bad. And I know that that amount is extreme.
No, not necessarily. I mean, it just depends on how much money have you all made selling real estate?
This year, we're at about $65,000 right now.
Okay. Can you not live on that?
Yes, we can live on that.
Why is he doing Uber?
Well, he just left his job where he was working, and he's getting his studying to get his real estate license. So we just didn't want to lose that income.
Why don't you make it up doing real estate?
You're right.
And you make more money in real estate than you can Uber. I like Uber as a second job. I endorse it. It's fine. And, I mean, I don't have a problem with that. But, I mean, in real estate, you have a natural second job, and that's work more real estate.
Correct.
And so you made $65,000 in the real estate business.
Yes, sir.
That's where I'd spend my time. And now the only thing you need to hold in the business account when you're a real estate broker is enough to make sure your fees and your other miscellaneous real estate expenses are covered for next month. But you don't need to hold savings in that for a variable income.
Okay.
We do need to hold savings maybe at home for a variable income. But you guys are living well below what you make.
Right.
And as long as you keep doing that, you're not even going to need the savings for a variable income because your variable income on your worst possible day is not going to be below that.
Right. So next month, in my commissions, I'll bring approximately $15,000. So
I'd pay that off.
Pay the student loan.
I start paying these debts off, yeah.
Okay.
And get this car paid off. You're doing great in real estate. You need to use that money to get yourself clear.
Okay. And so for him, don't worry about Uber. Just keep studying until he can get done with it.
When will he finish his license?
Well, he's doing it online, so he should be done by the end of this month. By the end of September.
For his pre-licensing?
Yes, he's been doing it for a couple months.
Why does it take 2 months? You ought to be able to do it in a week.
I know, but because he's been working.
But he doesn't work now.
Well, he's still working part-time with me.
I thought he quit his job.
He quit his job.
He's working part-time with you. He needs to, listen, that pre-licensing is not that tough in Georgia.
Correct.
That doesn't need to take a month. That needs to take less. He ought to be done by Sunday night.
Okay.
Well, you ain't got anything else to do. Go get it done. Turn off the TV.
Okay.
It's not something that needs to be drug out, because he needs to get that done so he can sit for his test so he can be legal.
Okay.
And then you guys can kid it into overdrive.
Right.
Because he can't show a house right now.
Right.
It's illegal in Georgia to show houses when you don't have a license.
Right.
So the amount of help he is to you is limited to secretary duty.
Right. That's true.
And, man, you guys can turn this up, but let's get with it. Let's kick this thing in gear.
Okay.
I mean, if it was some kind of taking a CPA or the bar or something, it'd be different. But that test is not that hard.
Right.
It's doable. You can knock that out because it's online, and then the test is probably online in Georgia, isn't it?
No, he actually does have to go take the test.
You physically sit for it?
Yes, he does.
But it's computerized?
Yes, it is.
Gives you your answer right then?
Yes.
Are you legal that day?
You are legal that day because he'll put his license where I'm at.
Yeah. Well, crap, let's get the license by next Friday.
Okay.
And get this thing going. That's what I would do.
Okay. Can I ask one question?
Right quick.
So when you and your wife did the envelope system, because we're on the envelope, we're sold out wholeheartedly with that. Mm-hmm. So like gas, obviously he needs gas for his vehicle. I need gas for my vehicle.
We had his and her.
Gotcha.
His and her. And we quit using it for gasoline because I'm too lazy to walk in the store and pay the bill. I just use a debit card. I'm standing right there at the pump. It costs me 3 trips back and forth if I got to do it otherwise. So I don't use envelope system for that anymore. But we do use it for food. We do use it for clothing and so on.
Okay.
All right. Hey, thanks for the call. You're doing good stuff. You're on a roll. I think you guys are a whole lot better than you're giving yourselves credit for. Let's get this thing geared up and get rocking. You're incredible. You're on the way. That puts this hour of the Dave Ramsey Show in the books. Thanks to James Childs, our producer. Blake Thompson's our executive producer. Kelly Daniel, our associate producer and phone screener. I'm Dave Ramsey, your host, and we'll be back.
Hi, I'm Dr. Bob Marshall, PhD, host of Healthline. Join me live to get your questions answered and hear the latest breakthrough information for you and your family. Our product line, Quantum Nutrition Labs, delivers what others only promise.